Good evening friends, welcome to my channel. I'm Mr. Venkat. Today I'm going to explain about numbers in English. You might be shocked by reading the topic numbers in English, but I'm telling you, don't get shocked, don't get panicked, don't get any confusion, but even in English we have numbers. You might be getting, sir, what are you going to teach? Are you going to teach mathematics or English? But remember, I'm not going to teach mathematics, but I'm going to teach English only. But remember, even in English, we have numbers. So here I have written, there are two numbers in English. They are the singular, the plural. We have numbers in English. And I want everyone, before, while I am going to teach, I want everyone just pay attention. When I am going to start, I want everyone to be smart. And I am going to begin, I want everyone to win. Because here my meaning of win is, you need to understand, you need to know, you need to grasp what I'm going to teach. And then finally, when I'm going to teach, when I'm going to demonstrate, I want all of you concentrate. My dear friends, concentration is very important. Without concentrating, we can't understand anything. So, in this video, I make you clear about these numbers. So, as I said, the first one is the singular number, the second one is the plural number. What is singular number? It denotes one person or thing. Or in other words, you can remember, singular means single, only one. So it refers only one person or one thing. And then plural means it denotes more than one person or thing. That's a plural number. Now, already we have learnt about parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech in English. Out of these 8, only for 3 parts of speech, we have these singular and plural numbers. Now, we don't have for other parts of speech these singular and plural numbers. For what we have the singular and plural numbers. So see, first one, noun, singular and plural. And here I have written a few examples: book, bus, knife, ox, tooth, etc. And plurals are books, buses, knives, oxen, teeth, etc. So we all knew very well about noun, that noun has singular and plural. And now come to pronoun. And even in pronoun, we have singular and plural. What are the singular pronouns? What are the plural pronouns? The singular pronouns are I, you, he, she, it. The plural pronouns are we, you, they. And then again here, if we see, you is written in singular and plural. My dear friends, try to understand here, you can be used as singular and plural. Let me give one example to you. For example, if I am talking to a sir, I can say, sir, you are great, sir. You are great. I am talking to a single person, but I am using or. So, you are. If I am in the classroom, I am talking to the children, I am talking to the students, then I can say, you are good children. Here, you refers to the students, which is plural. So, like this, we can use you as singular and plural. And they. These are singular pronouns and these are plural pronouns. My dear friends, listen to me very carefully. And the third one, wo. And it might be surprising to you, or it might be strange to you, having singular and plural in wo. But let me tell you, even in wo, we have singular and plural. We have singular verbs and we have plural verbs. So this is a new concept, I think, and I want everyone pay attention and try to understand about this singular verbs and plural verbs. So now first let us see singular verbs. Here I have written am, is, was, has, does, plays, goes. All these are singular verbs. And then next one, plural, or else plural verbs, or wo, have, do, play, go. So let me explain to you clearly about these singular verbs. And how can we remember these singular verbs in an easiest way? I'm going to tell you. You can remember singular verbs in an easiest way. That I'm going to tell you, please remember. See here, if you see all the singular verbs, they are ending with S, except one verb, that is am. You see once here, is, there is S, was, S, has, S, does, S, like this. In all the singular verbs, the ending letter is S. That's why here you see, singular, it will start with S. So, we can remember these singular verbs, the end letter. If any verb ends with S, that is singular verb. Is it clear? If you find any verb ending with S, except am. Am is also singular verb, but it is the only verb that's not ending with is. Except am, remaining all verbs, they will end with S. And if you find any verb ending with S, that is singular verb. And then again here, see, I have written V1 plus S or ES. What is V1? Already I have explained very clearly about a verb in my first video, that is a verb and its classification. And V1 means present tense, V1 means base form, V1 means root form, and even we can call V1 as infinitive. Please, if you understand about V1 or about verb, please listen to my video so that you can learn about verb very clearly. And see, listening is very important, as I said, as I repeat this one. And the more you listen, the better you understand. The more you listen, the better you remember. You remember. So that's why we have to listen to our teachers. We have to listen to when somebody is speaking. Like this we have to remember. Now, come to plural verbs. Now, how can we remember plural verbs? See, plural verbs will not end with S. Plural verbs will not end with S. So here, V1. If only the verb is V1, that is plural verb. So here, I forgot to tell you, V1 plus S or S means V1. Suppose, see here, the verb is play. And here, we have S is added here, plays. And here, the verb is, V1 is go. And we have added S. So, but the last letter is yes. Yes. So here only V1, if the verb is V1, that is plural verb. So my dear friends, remember, even in verb, we have singular verb and plural verb. And listen to me, and this concept is very important for us to understand and to remember. You may ask me, why? Because generally, if we make a sentence, as I told you, the sentence starts with subject, verb, object or complement. Subject, In subject part, most of the time we take noun or pronoun. Nouns are used as subjects, pronouns are used as subjects, and after that these are followed by verb. And now remember, here between subject and verb there is a relation. In English, a verb must agree with its subject. It has to agree. What is that agreement? Let me tell you here. If the subject is singular, the verb is singular. That is one rule. And then the second rule, if the subject is plural, the verb is plural. Okay, this concept is very important. Whether the subject is singular or plural, we need to understand, and according to that we are supposed to use the verb. Okay. So once again I repeat, in English we have two rules. Mainly there are many other rules, but the two rules are, the prominent two rules are, if the subject is singular, the verb is singular. If the subject is plural, the verb is plural. Now we have learnt about the singular verbs and plural verbs. And then again here, there are two sentences here. Ravi has a pen. My friends have books. And in first sentence, Ravi is the subject, which is a singular subject. That's why the verb is singular. In second sentence, my friends is subject and it is plural. That's why the verb is plural. And then again here, we have exceptions for this. Now, once you see this sentence, I have a car. In this sentence, I is the subject and I is singular subject. But verb is plural verb. Already I have written here, have is plural verb. But here, for I, there is a special usage is there in English. Even though I is singular, but we are supposed to use the verb have, that is plural. And then again the second one, you are a student, you are students. And if you read these two sentences, here the verb is are and here also the verb is are. And once see subject, you is the subject here and you is the subject, and in this sentence you is singular subject and here you is plural subject. But whether you is singular subject or plural subject, we are supposed to use or take plural verb only. So these are the two exceptions we have for this. So this is very important to understand. Even in verb we have singular and plural. If you like this video, please subscribe it. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.